What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, y'all, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but for some of y'all, you're not gonna like what I have to say today. Well, sometimes the truth hurts, and I'm here to be a truth teller. And the truth, y'all, is that Kamala Harris can win. I know that don't sit well with some of y'all, and I know she has been coronated and selected and not elected, and we don't even know if she's going to remain the Democrat nominee. We'll find out at the convention. I hear some people are quite upset with the way things unfolded. Some people who were allied with Joe Biden and felt like the party stabbed him in the back. Well, if she remains the nominee, y'all, I think she can win. How they gonna do it? Easy. Age-old tactic, divide and conquer. And I hear a lot of people saying, well, she's going to lose a big chunk of the black vote, and she might. But it's still divide and conquer. Why is that? Because take a look at black men. Black men have been falling away from the Democrat Party in recent years, but in this particular election more so. Black men are saying, I'm not voting for Kamala. My money was longer under Trump. My employment options were better under Trump. My prospects for home ownership were better under Trump. I'm rocking with that. It's the economy, stupid. It's also the border. It's also the faith. And the left-wing party leaning towards all of this transformer identity politics that black men just ain't going for. So what do you have? Black men who are going to vote right. Ah, but not so fast, y'all. Because what are black preachers typically? Black men. And if you step foot in a black church these days, you're going to find black preachers advocating for Kamala Harris. Just like they were advocating for Joe Biden. They turned on a dime, y'all. Make you think it wasn't ordained by God at all. You got all these black preachers in lockstep, wedded to the Democrat plantation, and they gonna rock with it, roll with it. So you got a split in a split. Well, what about black women? Black women are more educated in numbers than black men. They vote in higher numbers than black men. And black women are going to rock out with Kamala because as much book smarts as they tend to have, don't really have practical smarts. And they run it around believing Kamala is black. Because she's an AKA, because she went to an HBCU. I wonder what box she checked on her HBCU application. Just rub, erase that little red dot off her forehead, check black, and she's admitted. Well, the sisters gonna rock with her. The AKA is gonna spread the word. Ski-wee. Now you have a split within a split there as well, because some of these black women gonna follow their black husbands, those black men who are leaning right. But most of the black women are gonna follow these black preachers who are leaning left. You see, you go in a modern black church and ain't many men in there. It's full of women. You got one black man in there and he's at the podium. Well, he's going to direct these black women to vote for Kamala, and they will. What about the Latinos? Well, Latinos are interesting because when they come here from Latin countries, they have certain beliefs, they have certain faith, they have certain ethics. Many of them. Hard work, nuclear family, Catholic beliefs, many of them. Well, the Latino man that is eligible to vote, we're not talking about them other ones who just ran across. Those who are eligible, the Latino man is going to side with Trump. Why? Because Latino men don't like what's going on the border either. Latino men like making money. So it's the border, it's the economy. It's their family and it's their faith. Not too different from Black men who are leaning right. But what about Latinas? Well, that's where you got a little split. Rarely will you see the Latinas rocking with the Black women. When they come and they take on an American identity, it ain't Black. Let's just be real. I said I was going to tell the truth, right? They'll put some highlights in the hair, talk a certain way, and they'll identify with white women. So where the Latinas going to go with their vote? My prediction, that's all this is. These are my predictions. I believe the Latina vote will be split. Some of them will ride it out with their male counterparts and stick with family and faith, border security, and economy. But some of them have been brainwashed by feminism. Can we just be honest? Some of them gonna rock out with the feminist agenda. Seems self-detrimental, doesn't it? Seems almost suicidal, doesn't it? But they're going to do it. And I understand, y'all, we got so many different ethnicities in America. America is the melting pot, as they say. But a lot of those other ethnicities don't move the needle as much as Black folks, Latinos, and white folks. That's just what it is in America. So what are white folks going to do? Well, it's pretty simple. White men are voting for Trump. No, not the effeminate white men. Not the white men who think they're white women. No, not the white men who identify as something else. No, we're talking about the typical American white male. Will be voting for Trump en masse. Kamala's not going to get that vote. However, when you look at their female counterpart, and it took me a while to get here, but we're here now. The white woman in America holds the key to this election. I don't care how you slice it. I don't care how you put it. She holds the key to the lock. And here, once again, division will come in because you're going to have a certain segment of white women who go with their husbands. Say, I'm going to vote for the economy and the border. I'm going to vote for the nuclear family. And we good old Christians. So I'm going to rock out with Jesus in the voting booth. I'm going to do that. But where do you think Me Too comes from? Where do you think the feminist movement comes from? Where do you think the abortion movement comes from? Where do you think all of these left-wing ideas come from? White women, white, liberal, racist women. And there's a lot of them. And they want girl power. They want woman power. They know Trump is not going to give it to them. So they're going to support Kamala. No matter the policy, no matter the direction of the country, no matter the border security, no matter the economy, nah, these are the purple-haired white women. These are the pink and green-haired white women. These are the nose-pierced and lip-pierced white women. They gonna rock out with Kamala. And they number in the millions. Just look on TikTok. You'll see them. They're trying to rally the troops. So what does that mean for America? It means that the future of America is in the hands of white women who are also divided. And at this point, nobody knows which way they'll go. So it's important to put the truth out here and say, yes, Kamala can win. You right-wingers. Don't rest on your laurels. Don't feel like you got it in the bag. At this point, no one has it in the bag. It's going to be a fight to the end. You better run through the tape. Now, all of these predictions are subject to change, but I feel pretty confident in what I know, that this is about how it's going to go. I'm not putting any trust in any of these groups. I'm not putting any faith in any of these groups. My faith is in God and God alone, because I know the potential of the people. I know what they're capable of, good and bad. And if I could quote A quote attributed to the late great H.L. Mencken says, "No one has ever gone broke underestimating the intelligence of the American people." And I stand on that. Any one of these groups can be dumb and vote against their own interests. We'll see. But if that happens in certain numbers, yes, she can win. We'll see how it works out. What do y'all think about the odds of Kamala Harris being the next president of the United States? Let me know in the comments. I'd like to know what you think. And don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.